The High Resolves Partnership is key to what we do to bring students from school into university. And we found it's been a great partnership and a very successful program.
In order to make access to university equal for all, we need to make sure that early on in young people's lives, we're talking to them about university. We're talking to them about the fact that they can get there, they can do it, and we're making the pathways easier for them to get there.
So this program is really to bring young people in a great learning environment that is high tech, that's got all the facilities university has.
What's good about this program is it shows you the world.
It takes a significant global issue and develops their ability to work as teams and to solve it.
You have each been chosen by your governments to represent the interests of your country in this global effort to tackle climate change.
It really starts to get you thinking about both individual and collective responsibility for global problems and how to start to problem solve in a space that respects the understanding and wisdom of others, which of course is the key to diplomacy.
The floor is now open for you to address the group if you wish.
So first of all, I'm going to address every country. 100% is really good. It keeps the units high, so climate change, getting rid of it, but it also keeps costs low at 34.
So I was Pakistan, and my strategy at the beginning, realistically, if you're doing something brand new, you wouldn't go all in straight away. And if you're a good country, you wouldn't just not do it at all. So 25% seemed good. After a while, I sort of figured out the strategy that if everyone went 100%, it'd save costs.
It will show them that a university is not a scary place. A university is for anyone and everyone who would like to participate in further study beyond school.
For many of the students, it's the first time they've been at a university. So it opens up their eyes. They're there with their peers, so it's not too confronting. Like, they're there with a whole lot of people like them. And we also use equity ambassadors, university ambassadors, who often have similar backgrounds to the students themselves, can talk about their own story, can mentor them. We know that that sort of peer-to-peer support is really effective as well.
I think it's actually pretty good. It looks nice and it's fun to walk around, look at everything.
I noticed it's not as small as I thought it'd be, and it's a lot more nature. It's nice and it's very big.
I'm just loving them walking around and using collaborative skills and seeing them in a different way that I probably would in the classroom. I think they've actually stepped up today. I'm really proud of them because they're a younger cohort.
And this team got 100 points, which means this team are the winners!
I was surprised by how engaged they were just in the process. Everyone was really interested in what they were doing. Everyone wanted to network and have their goals met for their country, and just how engaged they were, really.
The kids were just willing to take a risk from the moment they came in. I could feel that they felt empowered. They felt a sense of importance, and it really resonated through all the choices they were making in the simulation, right down to when they entered the room. They were here and they were ready for it.
What that shows is that the students have the academic ability, they just need the vision of actually what a university degree can provide.
Students have been very inquisitive. They've had a lot of fun questions, like what the social life was like. We felt lonely at UTS. They were quite concerned about that as well, but also practical and logistical concerns. There's a lot of support from services that UTS provides, but also one-on-one relationships with your tutors. They looked at the new buildings and they thought, well, this is really cool. This is a place that I could actually belong to.
I love the support system that the university actually has for the students. Some of the students from Year 8 actually had questions more so to do about the financial aspect of university, which is something I didn't even consider until I was applying for university. So that's something that just made me realise that possibly the cost of university could be a barrier for them to actually get into university or even wanting to apply at all. And we actually do have financial assistance and financial aid, even scholarships that are degree specific or just in general equity related scholarships.
The activities we did, they were fun. It certainly wasn't talking and just listening, it was more engaging. It was great.
Who thinks they did a good job at minimising their national costs and reducing global emissions?